everybody. This is Anne. Today I'm going to show you how to make 3 jars using unique decorating techniques to achieve the look and feel of the calming seashore. Let's get started. First, I throw the pots. Using 1 pound of white porcelain clay, I cone it up and down to center it on the bat. Next, I hollow out the center and compress the clay floor. I then start to pull up the walls. I tried different shapes for this project and found that a pot with a wide bulbous belly and a thinner neck works very well to highlight the wavy texture and the smaller decorative elements. It's important to start out with a nice smooth surface before decorating your pot. This is where ribbing will be very helpful. If you'd like to learn more about using the ribs, check out our other YouTube video for tips. Once the jar is thrown, I divide it into 3 sections with the largest section in the middle, but also leaving enough room at the top section for smaller decorations. Let's add the waves to the seashore. Using a sharp edge of a wooden rib, flattened and slightly angled, position the rib at the lower dividing line. Push the edge of the rib into the fresh clay and wiggle it slightly while the wheel is slowly turning. Upon each revolution of the wheel, move the rib up about 1/4 inch. Continue doing this until you reach the upper dividing line. Notice that your waves have ragged edges. Leave that for now, we'll clean it up later. Note that the wavy clay is now pushed inward. Use your rubber rib on the inside of the pot to push the clay back out. The pot is leather hard. Now's the time to soften the sharp edges. Gently use a damp sponge against the waves. Repeat this wavy texture technique for each of the 3 pots. Now onto the decorative elements. For the first pot, we use an underglaze wicking technique over a design transfer. We're going to start with a simple blocky drawing on regular paper. I have included links to these particular drawings in the description below if you want them, but you can use your own drawing if you like. Just make sure your drawings fit within the design area. Cut out your drawings, then using a sharp graphite pencil, blacken the back of the paper. Position the drawing where you want it on the pot and tape it in place. Using an ink pen, trace the lines of your drawing to the clay. Using your needle tool, shallowly carve over your drawing lines. With a paintbrush, gently brush away the clay crumbs. If the carving leaves sharp, jagged edges, dampen the brush and soften those edges. To add color to your carvings, I choose a bright colored underglaze and water it down. I load the brush with the underglaze and then dab it onto the surface of the clay. The carved lines will wick up the underglaze and diffuse it along the carved ditches. Next, I underglaze the wavy areas. Using the Amoco Baby Blue, I brush the entire area with several coats of the light blue and let it dry. Now I take a damp sponge and wipe it over the raised areas, removing the color. Remember to rinse out the sponge after every 2 or 3 sponge passes. Also, if you remove too much color, it's easy to paint it on again and give it another go. Once you get all the colors on the pot, you'll know how they interact. If you're not happy, you can take a damp sponge and swipe it over the top to remove any underglaze from the surface. You can always repeat the process of carving, applying underglaze and sponging off until you get the look that you want. For the second pot, we're going to do hand drawing and underglaze painting. This is my favorite. Draw your favorite seashore images. In this case, I love the seashells with the line divisions. I usually group them together in groups of 2 or 3 around the pot. Now I'm going to use underglaze painting for a splash of color. I could talk hours about underglaze painting techniques, but if you'd like a more in-depth course on using underglazes, check out my video workshop series in the links below. These detailed courses provide step-by-step instructions on how to create beautiful images on clay. For the third pot, we're going to create appliques using a commercial candy making mold. I found this particular mold at the craft store. First, dip a paintbrush in cornstarch and coat the inside of the mold to keep the clay from sticking. Dump out any remaining cornstarch like you were flouring a cake pan. Then pinch off a small amount of clay and roll it into a tight ball so that you have a coned point on top. Position the clay with the cone straight down into the mold and press over the back of the entire surface so it comes in contact with all the ridges of the mold. Using your wire tool, wire away any clay that extends beyond the opening. For this pot, I'm making 4 shells, which I'll place symmetrically around the pot. I turn the pot so I can see the top rim, then mark the center points along the north, south, east, and west points. This will be where I place each applique. To apply your applique, score both the underside of the applique and the surface of the pot where you want it. Brush a little slip onto one of those scored areas and firmly attach. I use a damp paintbrush around the outside of the applique to give it a good seal. Again, I apply the blue underglaze in the same way that we did on the other pots to the wavy texture. Now I apply the underglazes in a dabbing motion until I'm happy with the results. When they're totally dry, bisque fire and then glaze the way that you like. For more information about the products I used in this video, I've added links to them below. If you like our videos, please subscribe and share. See you next time in the studio.